Hey, this is Ben here, and I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this effect where you can draw different types of textures onto different types of models. You can draw up to four different types at once. I know it does a little bit of flickering, but I'm not sure why it does that. But I think that is kind of a bug with the drawing tool, but not so much with the shader. So, cool. Let's jump right into it so we can create this effect. Okay, so in order to set up this vertex painting effect, what we want to do is have one of Unity's packages. It's called polybrush. What this allows us to do is it allows us to paint in the vertex color. As you can see on this black sphere, I can now paint the color red. You can kind of go online and Google for yourself to learn how to use polybrush. But what we're doing here is we are painting in the red in the vertex color. Now, in order for this vertex color to be displayed, this sphere needs a special render, a special shader. As you can see here, it's called the Vertex Textures. And all we're doing is creating the color channel in the app data, color in the V2F. In a vertex shader, what we're doing is we're just assigning the vertex color right onto the O.color of the V2F, and then we're just displaying the color, as you can see here. The reason why we want to do this is because we're going to use each color to determine one channel or a mask for each texture. So I'm going to go ahead and set up four other textures. We have main text here already, but I'm going to copy this and create four other textures. I'll just call it main text 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, so we have our four textures set up. If we go back to our we do have an error. One second here. So the error we're facing is just that main text here is no longer defined. It just needs to be main text 1. All right, cool. So let's go ahead and display each mask, or sorry, each main text based on the vertex color. So it'll look something like this. So color will be color 1, and we'll duplicate this 4 times. So as you can see, we have now 4 colors based on 4 main textures. For now, we're gonna use the same UV. And then we simply multiply this by our color.r for the first one, green for the second one, blue, and then alpha. Here at the end, we're going to return the four colors added together. Now, to make sure this works well, let's add 4 textures onto here. I'm just going to pick 4 random ones, maybe a water one. The issue we're facing here is because the UVs, I think I might have removed them when I was creating this file. So let's just make sure they are passed through properly. We'll just pass them through directly for now. Great. All right. It looks like it's working now. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to, instead of returning the final color, for now, I'm going to return the vertex color. So just so that we can see what we are working with. It will be just return vertex color or i.color, and it'll look like this. Cool. Let's go ahead and use the poly brush to paint in a couple other colors onto this thing. I won't do it exactly, perfectly, but I'll just do it in a way where it's a little bit easier to understand and see what is going on. I'm also painting alpha right now, and unfortunately we can't actually see it, but it should still be working. I'll show you when we actually do the texture later. Cool. All right, let's go ahead and now display, instead of the i.color, let's display the actual texture. Now it doesn't seem like it has worked. It seems to have added all of these colors on top of each other. I'm going to try to figure out what is going on here. I see what's going on here. As you can see, just by adding the first three colors, we are getting the three different textures that we're expecting. So, well, let's focus on the first three for now. Instead of this gray one, I'm gonna choose this picture. So you can kind of see a bit of it here, right? You can kind of see it happening here. We see this eye texture here. And for this one, let's choose something else, like maybe, brick. Yeah. So we can see how it's blending from this second texture to the brick texture, which is the first one, to the eye. But as soon as I add on color four, it goes out of whack. The reason why is because color four is alpha, and by default, alpha is fully lit. So what we want to do is actually, instead of drawing alpha, we want to eliminate alpha. For the polybrush to do that, let's see if I can use the flood to get rid of it. I'm just going to go here, create a black texture, no alpha, and there. One click and I've removed it, and then I'm just going to brush it on manually. So when it comes to alpha, I can paint in black and full alpha. So now you can see how, when I paint here, it's a little bit watery. I'm not really sure why it's flickering like this. It shouldn't. This is looks like an issue with polybrush. Hopefully your version of Unity does not have this issue. But yeah, with this tool, now I can switch to red, and red will be painting the brick texture. One second. Oh, and of course this you can actually change it to white now. And then make sure you only have the R channel selected, and now you can paint the brick texture, right? You can also paint whatever's in the green channel, which is this colorful face texture, right? So yeah, so you can actually paint multiple colors onto one sphere. So we're going to upgrade this a little bit, because right now we're going to take advantage of the main text ST on each of these. So I'm just gonna go ahead and quickly create that. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create all of the ST stuff here. So main text 2, 3, and 4 ST, right? Next, our UVs, we need more channels. So we're gonna change this to a float 4. And I'm going to call this UV1. All of these will be now UV1. And I'm also going to create a new set over here. So actually, for the UVs coming from the app data, it can just stay as UV and stay as float 2. But the one here needs to be UV1, and this needs to be float 4. We also need a new set of UVs because we have four textures, which needs 8 UVs, right? So we're gonna do UV1 and UV2, both being float 4. That gives us a set of 8, or a set of 4, but 8 variables, right? We're gonna put it in text coordinate 2. So this will now be O.UV1 is equal to V. So in order for us to assign UV1, we're going to use transform text. We're going to continue to use the v.uv of main text 1. And our o.uv1 will just be xy. And we're going to duplicate this 4 times. This will stay as UV1, and we'll use the other two channels, so ZW. This will be UV2, XY is fine, UV2 again, and we'll use the other two channels, ZW. leaving this at v.uv is okay. And we just need to do main text 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here, when we're trying to use the UVs, we just use UV1.xy. This one would be ZW. 2.xy. 2.zw. And that should be it. If I go back to here, nothing will change until I start to tile things here. So I can actually tile just the brick texture, as you can see. I can tile just the colorful texture, or even offset it if I feel like it, right? I can do the same for the eye texture, wherever it is, it's right here. I can do it 2x2 or even more, let's just say 10, right? And I can do the same for water too. Let's go with 20. And I have very dense water here. So yeah, I know this particular sphere is not the most exciting thing to look at, but I do hope that this is something that kind of helps you, paint different models that artists kind of give you, and you can kind of create all sorts of really cool effects and models for your games. So yeah, that is it for this particular video. If you guys like what you see, please like, subscribe, and support my channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye now.